Hey people, it's Tuesday, February the 23rd, and it is 1:20 in the afternoon, and it is plus 4 degrees Celsius. And I'm here just at the corner of Yonge Street and Finch Street. I just came out of Finch subway station. And I'll be walking north on Yonge, up past Steeles Avenue, outside of the city of Toronto, and into York region. It's kind of a windy day, so I'll try to talk when the wind's not blowing. But as of yesterday, York region, just north of the city of Toronto, entered the red zone, which means that stores and restaurants can have indoor shopping and indoor dining with limited capacity, and gyms and hair salons, and I'm not sure about movie theaters, but maybe movie theaters as well, can all have patrons return with limited, you know, capacity and limited numbers. So I thought it would be kind of interesting just to walk across Steeles Avenue, which is the border, as I was saying. Yeah, I wanted to wait for the wind to die down before I tried talking again. So Steeles Avenue is the border between the city of Toronto and York region, and the city of Toronto is still in lockdown and is still in the stay-at-home order until at least March the 9th. And I've never done a video walking along this part of Yonge Street north of Finch before. And I've never done a video where I walk from the city into the suburbs. I did a video once where I rode the subway into Vaughan. to Vaughan Metropolitan Centre Station, but I've never walked across the boundary before, so it's the first time. There's a big development. I think that used to be an old shopping plaza. Lots of the old shopping plazas up in these outer areas of the city are being redeveloped into new residential towers. I rode the subway from Dundas Station, which is the closest subway station to where I live, and to Pinch Station. It took about 35 minutes. And I'm guessing it'll take around the same amount of time to walk up past Steeles Avenue. There are plans in the future to extend the subway line up to Steeles and beyond into York Region, along Yonge Street. Get a look at the new development there. I think this northern part of Yonge Street leading up to Steeles has a lot of Iranian businesses, if I'm not mistaken. A little further south, going into Willowdale, it becomes Korean. The historic community of Newtonbrook. It's one of the old villages that grew up along this part of Yonge Street, although there's not much left of it, I think, at this point, in terms of original old buildings and houses. Most of this has been pretty redeveloped in the post-war era. That's when most of this area was built out. These old slab apartment buildings. Most of these sprung up in the late 60s and early 70s. See, this area is looking pretty suburban up here. These are the far-flung northern reaches of the city. Of course, at one time this was North York. It still is North York to most people, but it's technically part of the city of Toronto now. North York and the other boroughs all amalgamated with the old city of Toronto in 1998. Tehranto, I like that. That is quite the jam-packed, busy-looking plaza there. Everything seems to be open as well. So we have not crossed Steeles Avenue yet, by the way. That's still a little ways up ahead. See lots of York Region transit buses that come down into the city, go to Finch Station, and you got your regular old TTC buses as well. And, you know, thinking about it, I have not walked on this part of Yonge Street since the 90s. Yeah, the 90s was the last time my feet were on this sidewalk. There's a York Region Viva bus. This is Centerpoint Mall. I think this is an old 1960s era shopping mall. Thank you. course, everything is closed in this mall, except for curbside pickup for some stores that offer that. But if this mall was literally just a few hundred meters to the north, it would be open for business right now. And here we are, Steeles Avenue. So this is the northern boundary of the city of Toronto. And it runs across the entire top of the city. And on the other side is, I think, Markham on one side of Yonge and Vaughan on the other side. So boom, we are no longer in Toronto. And all these places are open for indoor dining, indoor shopping. I think being in the red zone, these places can have 50% capacity for indoor shopping. And I think up to 10 people indoors for indoor dining. bike on the sidewalk. It's trying to run me over. When you get up into these suburban areas, you have to really watch yourself as a pedestrian. Cars reign supreme up here. You can tell we're not in Toronto anymore when you see these street signs are now green. Not a whole lot in terms of restaurants and stores on this particular stretch, but rest assured, wherever they are, they're all probably very busy right now. Life is somewhat normalish here, in contrast to on the other side of Steeles Avenue. So I think I will wrap this video up here at this intersection, straight ahead. Maybe I'll cross Yonge Street just to get a shot looking up and down Yonge Street to end it. Jeez, you can see tall buildings just going up in the far-off distance. The suburbs of Toronto are going vertical. Alright, this is crossing Yonge. There we go, looking south, down towards the city. And looking north, in the vast reaches of suburbia. So, I hope you enjoyed this little walk up Yonge Street from Finch Station across the Steeles Avenue boundary into York Region. If you did, please, by all means, subscribe, like, share, comment, tell your friends and your family. And be sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. I've been posting daily lately. And if you'd like to support the channel, there's a link in the description where you can do so via PayPal. I'm also on Instagram under KContinuum if you'd like to look me up. And keep an eye out for my next live stream. I should be doing another one in the near future. So thanks for watching, and be sure to keep checking back because, as always, I will continue.